Okay, this is ugly, don't you think? Hey guys, welcome back to the Flame channel, and today I invited one of my Japanese friends to talk about her life experience with us today as an exchange student in America, and her name is Angelina, and I'm calling her now.
もしもし, 聞こえる?
もしもし, 聞こえる. 久しぶり, 元気?
元気よ. あ、今大丈夫?
大丈夫.
はい. So, Angel san, 日本語忘れたから英語で喋ろ?
Okay.
Alright, so Angel, I'm calling you today to ask you to share your life experience as a Japanese exchange student in the United States. And the question is going to be, how do you make the most of your time in the United States as a foreign exchange student? Can you share some tips with us, please?
Of course.
But yeah, first of all, could you briefly introduce yourself, please?
Hi guys, my name is Angelina. I am from Japan. This is my third year of staying in the United States as a foreign student. I graduated from high school this May and I'm going to college this fall. I really enjoy spending time here in the United States.
Oh, okay. Okay, Angel, thank you for that. Are you ready to share some tips with us now?
Yes, I am.
Perfect.
I will give you guys 5 tips on how to make the most of your time in the US as a foreign student. Tip number 1, practice your English as much as possible. Since you're in the US, an English-speaking country, this is the best opportunity to practice your English. Just listening to English won't help improve your overall English.
Right.
You've got to speak it too in order to do so. Don't be afraid of making mistakes. English is not my first language. I'm still learning English, so I do make a lot of mistakes. Let me share what I do to practice and to improve my English. I ask my friends and host family to correct my English accent and grammar all the time. You actually learn a lot through making mistakes. That's why I don't hesitate to ask questions. Especially when I don't understand what people say or text. I will ask, what does it mean? Or I didn't understand it. Can you explain it to me, please? Those are effective ways of learning English.
I agree.
Tip number 2. Be specific on goals you want to achieve. To get score 100 on TOEFL, to get 4.0 GPA, to get into your dream school. Make it big. Also, don't forget to make daily goals as well. I believe every single step is important to achieve your goals. In my case, I wanted to keep a 4.0 GPA to get into my dream school because it requires higher English skills. So I'm trying to get into the habit of learning new English vocabulary and reading books or articles in English every day. It's a good idea to make a to-do list or something to get closer to your goals day by day. It's satisfying to cross off the list one by one, you know?
Yeah.
It keeps you motivated. Tip number 3, enjoy different cultures from many countries. I personally think the best part about studying in a foreign country is the cultural exchange. When you study in a foreign country, you will meet people from all over the world, people who have different backgrounds and nationalities.
Right.
As the time goes on, I learn to appreciate my heritage more than I used to. I'm often surprised by the differences in cultures and lifestyles. Those were very interesting and new to me. I'm grateful that I have opportunities to meet people from different countries because then we can learn about each other's life experiences that neither of us knew before. It's very fun to be with people with different cultures and customs.
Yeah.
Even though our backgrounds are different, we spend time together and become good friends. I'm so happy that I am bilingual because sometimes I feel like two different persons in my head.
Oh,
the reason being that I can think in two different languages, Japanese and English, which enables me to see in two different perspectives, if that makes sense.
Sure.
These experiences encouraged me to learn more languages. As a result, I made learning Spanish, Mandarin, and Korean as my hobby.
Whoa, three different languages.
Tip number four. Step out of your comfort zone. I'd like to share a quote by Brian Tracy. Move out of your comfort zone. You can only grow if you are willing to feel awkward and uncomfortable when you try something new. Like he said, you must try something new to grow. It can be anything. For example, join clubs, events, after school activities, or whatever. Even if you tried something and did not enjoy it, well, that's totally okay because it's a part of the learning process. Tip number five, have fun. Not everyone has this great opportunity to study in a foreign country, so be thankful and make it the best out of it. Study hard, play hard, try to go out on weekends with friends, going to see the sunset at the beach, taking a walk to a park, baking, cooking, visiting museums, theme parks. You have a lot of options. Oh, and also, you get to try food from many countries because America is very diverse. This is what I like about staying in America. I definitely recommend you to try explore lots of restaurants in your area. And yeah, those are the five tips I wanted to share with you guys today. I hope that they were helpful.
Oh, Angel, I totally agree with all the tips you shared with us today. They are super practical, I would say, and very helpful. When you study abroad, you just have to be like super open-minded, brave, and adaptive, right? And if you plan to do an exchange year, make sure you follow all the tips that Angelina had given you today, okay? This is all for your own good, right, Angel?
Right.
All right, Angel, thank you for your time today, Angel, and thank you for being here. Well, not really here, but thank you for being there and sharing the useful info with us. And I hope that we can meet up someday in Thailand, in Japan, or in the United States, I don't know. And also let me know if you happen to come to China. I go to college there.
Thank you for inviting me. It was fun. Sure. I'm glad that my tips were helpful for you guys. Have a great exchange year. And Flame, I will see you in Thailand someday for sure.
Okay, I will see you in Thailand. I hope you come, like, I don't know when, but please come.
Yes, I will. Okay, have a good day. Bye.
Okay, you too. Stay safe, stay healthy. Don't get infected, okay? And have a nice day. Bye. じゃあね。
ありがとう。ありがとう。
Thank you so much for watching this video. Please like, share, comment, and most importantly, subscribe to this channel to see more videos like this. I'll see you guys in the next videos. Stay safe, stay healthy, don't get infected, have a nice day. Bye.